Welcome to Examsdaily YouTube channel. In this video, we are going to see the daily current affairs of August 7, 2019. Before that, those who didn't subscribe our Examsdaily YouTube channel, click the subscribe button and also do not forget to click the bell button to get updates from our YouTube channel. Rajya Sabha passes Jammu and Kashmir reorganization bill. The government announced the repealing of Article 370, and this Article 370 grants special status to the Jammu and Kashmir. The resolution in this regard were adopted by the Rajya Sabha. The bill seeks to make Jammu and Kashmir a union territory with a legislature and also to make Ladakh a union territory without legislature. So here we can expect the question that the Rajya Sabha recently passes Jammu and Kashmir reorganization bill to make the Jammu and Kashmir to how many union territories, and that is two union territories, Jammu and Kashmir with legislature and Ladakh without legislature. Tree census in Mysuru soon. The Forest Department of Karnataka is going to roll out the first ever tree census within the next few weeks, and this is to estimate the tree numbers and ensure their protection to shore up the green cover of the city. And this tree census will make give the authorities a baseline data of the number of trees and also help assess the extent of the green cover in Mysuru. So here we can expect the question that which state's forest department is set to roll out the first ever tree census, and that is Karnataka. Green protocol for Nehru Trophy boat race. The green protocol will be strictly enforced during the 67th edition of the Nehru Trophy boat race, and this boat race is going to be held on Punnamada Lake in Kerala on August 10. And in this day, total of 79 boats, including 23 snake boats, is going to take part. So here we can expect the question that the 67th edition of the Nehru Trophy boat race is going to be held in which state, and that is Kerala. Rajasthan Assembly passes bill to curb honor killings and mob lynching. The Rajasthan Legislative Assembly recently passed two important bills, and that is to curb honor killing and mob lynching in the state. The first is Rajasthan Protection from Lynching Bill 2019, and the next is Rajasthan Prohibition of Interference with the Freedom of Matrimonial Alliances in the Name of Honor and Tradition Bill 2019. And these two bills were passed by the Rajasthan Assembly by a voice vote. So here we can expect the question that which state's assembly passes bill to curb honor killings and mob lynching, and that is Rajasthan. United States designate China a currency manipulator. The United States recently designated China as a currency manipulator, and this move could escalate the tense trade relations between the two countries, that is United States and China. So here we can expect the question that the United States recently designated which country as a currency manipulator, and that is China. Japan urged to sign UN nuke ban on Hiroshima anniversary. The mayor of Hiroshima urged Japan to sign a landmark UN treaty banning nuclear weapon, as the city on August 6 marked 74 years since being targeted in the world's first atomic attack. The Prime Minister of Japan, Shinzo Abe, led the commemorations at the Peace Memorial Park in Hiroshima, and this is to remember those killed in the August 6, 1945 Hiroshima bombing. So here we can expect the question that the Hiroshima bombing was held in which year, and that is August 6, 1945. Trump imposes total US freeze on Venezuelan government assert. The United States President Donald Trump imposed a freeze on Venezuelan government assets in the United States on August 5, 2019, and this sharply escalating a diplomatic and sanctions drive aimed at removing the socialist president of Venezuela, Nicolas Maduro, from power. So here we can expect the question that the US President Donald Trump imposed a freeze on which country's government assets, and that is Venezuela. Indian yug-eating snake spotted in Bukkapatna. A 2-foot-long Indian yug-eating snake has for the first time been spotted in Bukkapatna forest in Sira Taluk of Tumakuru district in Karnataka. The rare species, which is found in the Indian subcontinent, only eats birds' eggs, was spotted by the members of WARCO, that is Wildlife Awareness and Reptile Conservation. So here we can expect the question that Indian yug-eating snake was recently spotted in which state, and that is Karnataka. Artificial intelligence used to detect fast radio burst. The scientists from Australia have developed an automated system that uses the artificial intelligence to detect and capture the fast radio burst in real time. So this fast radio burst are mysterious and powerful flashes of radio waves from space thought to originate billions of light years from the Earth. And this was said by the researchers from Swinburne University of Technology in Australia. So here we can expect the question that which country scientists have developed an automated system that uses artificial intelligence to detect and capture the fast radio burst in real time, and that is Australia. Government unveils draft e-commerce norms. To protect the interest of online shoppers, the Department of Consumer Affairs has released the draft guidelines on e-commerce. And this draft guidelines state that an e-commerce entity cannot directly or indirectly influence the price of the goods or or services. So here we can expect the question that which department released draft guidelines on e-commerce recently? That is Department of Consumer Affairs. RBI penalizes 11 banks for violations. The Reserve Bank of India has recently imposed monetary penalty on 11 banks for non-compliance with certain provisions on fraud classification and reporting norms. So here we can expect the question that the RBI penalizes how many banks recently for non-compliance with certain provisions on fraud classification and reporting norms, and that is 11 banks. Second, All India Annual Conference of IIS Officers. The second All India Annual Conference of Indian Information Service Officers was organized at Pravasi Bharati Kendra in New Delhi. And the conference was organized with a view to attain greater integration of all media units under the Ministry of Information and Broadcasting in order to further amplify the government communication. So here we can expect the question that the second All India Annual Conference of IIS Officers was held in which city, and that is New Delhi. Workshop on role of technology in reuniting missing children and trafficked persons. A one-day workshop on role of technology in reuniting missing children and trafficked persons was jointly organized by the National Crime Record Bureau, Ministry of Home Affairs, in collaboration with the Indian Police Foundation on 5th August 2019 at NCRB Auditorium in New Delhi. Shri K.V. Apan, Secretary Department of Administrative Reforms and Public Grievances, inaugurated the workshop. So here we can expect the question that the workshop on role of technology in reuniting missing children and trafficked persons was held in which city? That is New Delhi. South Africa fast bowler Dale Steyn retires from Test cricket. The Dale Steyn, the legendary South African pacer, has announced his retirement from Test cricket. The Steyn made his debut in 2004 against England. He remains South Africa's leading wicket taker in Test match. So here we can expect the question that Dale Steyn is related to which sports? He is related to cricket. Hinako Shibuno wins British Open. Japan's Hinako Shibuno won a thrilling women's British Open golf tournament. She became the second Japanese to win a major, joining Chako Higuchi, who won the 1977 Women's PGA Championship. So here we can expect the question that who won the British Open golf tournament, and that is Japan's Hinako Shibuno. India beats Chinese Taipei in World Junior Squash Championship. India began its campaign on a fluttered note with a 3-0 win over the Chinese Taipei in Group C in the girls team event in the World Junior Squash Championship. So here we can expect the question that which country beats Chinese Taipei in World Junior Squash Championship, and that is India. So now we can see the important current affairs questions of the year 2019. First question, which Indian player has been recently named as ICC Women Cricketer of the Year 2018? The answer is Smriti Mandana. Second question, who has recently launched a toll-free number 14433 and also a facility to file complaints through Common Service Center? And the answer is National Human Rights Commission. Third question, who has been honored with the Kabi Samrat Upendra Banja National Award for Lifetime Achievement in Literature? And the answer is Manoj Das. Fourth question, which country has recently approved the issuance of first ever renminbi denominated bonds? And the answer is Pakistan. Fifth question, where does the Veer Savarkar International Airport, which has been recently declared as an authorized immigration checkpost, located? The answer is Andaman Nicobar Island. We have also given the quiz link. If you want to attend this daily current affairs quiz, you can use that link. Hope this will be useful. Thank you.